Good morning, singers. These are some comments about vocalizing or warming up the male voice, which I hope will be helpful to some people. There are some people who do not have to warm the voice up at all. Usually this happens when you're young. I found that in my youth, if I had gotten up and had enough physical activity so that the body was warmed up, that usually the voice was warmed up as well. And I didn't have to go through an hour or two of calisthenics to get the voice warmed. Some people are like that. Others require systematic warming. As I have gotten older, I'm now 66, the voice requires warming up, like most people's. So there is some system in how we do that, and I want to share that system with you. The very first phase of warming up is simply to get good blood flow going in the laryngeal area and to encourage stretch of tissues. So it is very much like calisthenics in a gym class in that regard. So in order to begin this phase, do not start at the lowest part of the voice. Start on a low note, which is comfortable, but not necessarily the lowest you can sing. And at this phase, simple five-tone scales are all that's required because they gently ask for the voice to stretch a little bit more each tone. And as it does that, then it encourages blood flow and the tissues begin to stretch. So if we simply begin with a low A, the first part of vocalizing is simply for that effect. Vocalizing, even at this phase, become aware of the passaggi points. The first passaggio for the male voice is the place at which the speaking voice would naturally end. At that particular place, which we call the first passaggio, some attention has to be given to round the vowel to prepare it to go into the upper parts of the chest voice and to eventually join into the head voice. This is called in Italian pedagogy arrotondamento, a progressive rounding. In my voice, the first passaggio is around F or G below middle C. So in that area, I have to pay a little attention to rounding the vowel at that point. If I don't do that rounding, then the voice begins to flatten out and the registration begins to be what is characterized in Italian pedagogy as voce aperta, something to be avoided at all cost. Voce aperta, an unschooled way of singing, would offer a sort of blatty vowel without the desired bouquet of upper partials. So if we did not round that first passaggio, it would sound like this. And that, unfortunately, would carry on up to this would be open voice, voce aperta, and is considered unschooled and untrained in Italian pedagogy. So again, with voce chiusa, the desired registration effect, after the rounding of the first passaggio, then there is continuity and preparation for the joining with head voice. Oh, after we have done this part of the voice in five tones, we don't just leap to head voice. We also warm up the chest voice with some arpeggiation, with some drills which require more stretch and require more blood flow. So for that, simple arpeggios are perfectly fine. Again, starting at a lower point in the voice, but not the lowest note. Now then, we're beginning to warm the chest voice up and to get it moving. And after doing that a little while, then we will go to moving scales. The scales that I like to use are 5 and 9 tone scales, because the 9 has a better rhythm for continuity than the 8 tone. So the 5 and the 9 sound like this. You see how the 9 makes an easy pivot so that you can go in one phrase up and down. But before you get into singing the 5 and 9 tones, now you can go back and begin to vocalize the low voice a little bit, whatever that is for you. The low voice, it begins to relax and to loosen up from the tightness it may have had when you first woke up. In this process, you can use some well-known phrases that go from the chest into the upper chest into the bottom. The Inquisitore's famous line. And then you can begin to arpeggiate that lower register. See if the lower voice feels more relaxed. Should have a very relaxed feeling in the throat now. You should have a feeling of relaxing down into the low register rather than pressing into it. Pressing into it will stiffen the vocalis muscles too much to enable the low notes to come in. The feeling of relaxation, relaxing into the low notes, is a feeling of relaxing the external thyroarytenoids and loosen the vocal cords. So the low notes require thick, loose vocal cords. And it's a feeling of relaxing down into the lower register. People who try to pinch their lower register to get out more sound always have a restriction at the bottom. So If you want to try to sing,
Sporafucci,
you'll be defeating yourself. You have not allowed the vocal folds to be vibrating at full length and with the relaxation they need. So don't bite the bottom. Let it flow in a relaxed way. Don't worry how loud it is. It's not supposed to be as loud as the rest of the voice. As we vocalize, we experience what's called an even intensity scale, which means that the low notes have less intensity and more intensity is gained as we go up the scale until we get into the high head voice, which has the most intensity. So don't try to make the low notes as loud as the upper chest or the head voice. They can't possibly be in a human larynx. So now that we've done that, we may be ready now to begin to use 5 and 9 tone scales to warm up the whole voice. Now, as you go up the scale, you inevitably encounter the second passaggio of the voice, which for basses is between D and E flat, and for baritones between D and E natural. That's the zone of the second passaggio. It is the place where the head voice or the covered voice initiates to allow the voice to go into the full head voice, which is what the Italian pedagogy means when it calls voce piena in testa, the full voice in the head, as to distinguish it from falsetto. It is also called voce completa because it completes the male voice. So in this area of the passaggio, the way of negotiating it is that when we reach the passaggio, we back off on air pressure, that is, we do not consciously try to push the voice. You can't literally judge air pressure by your feelings. That is being taken place well below the seat of consciousness. But you can control the sensation of pushing the voice. So when you reach the second passaggio, you do not push the voice, and you round the vowel to a closed or darkened vowel. The vowels which are normally closed, the back vowels, oo, 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 require no adjustment. Because they're already dark vowels, the second passaggio is very easily adjusted. Simply by not pushing the voice and keeping those closed vowels pure, the head voice will come in there. As we can show you here from an arpeggiation, which takes us up to E natural. We'll take the closed O vowel. There was a very easy entrance into the head voice, which did not sound like there was a big click in the mechanism, although there was a big shift, but it was quite disguised. Now, on the other hand, when we sing in the front vowels, the E and the A are also closed vowels, and they will easily also go into across the passaggio into head register as long as we don't push them. So here is an F arpeggiation using that E vowel. Only a slight opening of the jaw is required as we go up, but the E vowel easily enters into head register. The A, as in sera, likewise easily goes on this F sharp arpeggiation. Sera. So that only leaves us with two problematic open vowels, the E as in bella and the A is in patria. The open vowels must be shaded towards their closing. So Garcia gave us very plain instructions to that the open A closes as though it were moving towards O. Moving towards O, but not reaching there. We wouldn't want to sing patria in the chest and potria in the head voice. Doesn't require that much change. It does require, though, a little change, a little closing of the vowel towards for A towards O. Here again on the F arpeggiation. We'll sing the word patria, and you'll hear on the very tip-top F that there is a slight closing of the A. Notice it's not a big closing. It doesn't get too O. Neither is it a version of U, which is the direction that a lot of German pedagogy takes the voice. So the voice stays pure, but it does not completely go to O. That would be too much. If we sang patria again, and the top one we will modify completely to O. You see, that's unnecessary. And then your diction becomes difficult. Instead, again, with a proper adjustment of A, just barely closing it. Patria. So there we have a look at the entrance of the voice from chest into the second passaggio and emerging on the outskirts of that into the male head voice. So once then the passaggio has been well warmed up, then you can begin exercising the male head voice. Now, some people like to go back to original five tones. And let's do it first on a closed vowel where there's no difficulty. Let's say E. But as you can see, it did not change the vowel completely away from the E sound. Again, the proper adjustment avoids a huge vowel change. It's only a very small change, but it is an important change. Otherwise, the voice will be very tight as you try to go over the passaggio, and you won't be able to reach the final upper notes of whatever limits you have in the head register. And then if we're successful in five tones so that we can reach those easily, then we begin to arpeggiate them. So let's start back with the high G. Which is the penultimate note for so many baritones, and so many grand places for the baritone have the high A flat as the ultimate high note. For Verdi baritones and tenors who can sing above that, we exercise it very much the same way. Here would be the high C. So there, you see that the ultimate note in the high register still retains the ease and the flow of the rest of the voice. It does not start to pinch itself or to grab or to use constrictor muscles to pull the voice up, which was what we commonly hear. If we use the constrictor voice, the constrictor muscles, this is what it would sound like. We hear that everywhere, and that will hurt the voice as well as hurt the ears of the audience if they are discerning ears. So no arpeggiation can take you out of the flow and ease with which you have already warmed up the rest of the voice. So now then we can begin to exercise both registers, chest and head. And then as we continue to do that, we may use some passages, some heroic passages which require an abrupt entrance to that high register. That, of course, the prologue to Pagliacci. And you may continue that pattern to continue to warm up the rest of the voice. The ending to Celeste Aida is particularly difficult because it's asked to be sung piano. Most tenors, by the time they reach the ending of Celeste Aida, are much too tired to attempt to sing it piano. So now the voice, being fully warmed up, is ready to go on stage and to begin its characterization in whatever role it's doing. I hope these little tidbits about vocalizing have been helpful to you. Good singing!